is quite scary up here, and we are in a dock, not moving. It must be absolutely petrifying to be working on a rig like this out there in the open seas. And imagine all those centuries ago, no safety, no harnesses, just dangling off all of this. From up here, as beautiful as she looks, the SS Great Britain doesn't really look that innovative. Rigging, mast, wooden deck, all pretty standard stuff for a 19th century ship. Her real genius lies down there, beneath the waterline. This is it, Brunel's first iron-hulled ship. It was 100 feet longer and 1,000 tons heavier than anything that had come before it. It was the first modern ship, a true revolution.
Launched in 1843, the SS Great Britain was a leap into the unknown. Although iron ships were not new, they were still in their infancy. People just couldn't understand how one this size would stay afloat. In fact, iron ships were lighter than their wooden counterparts, which meant they could be built bigger and stronger. And they needed to be. A steamship this size needed vast reserves of coal to power her. Traditionally driven by paddles on the sides, Brunel did something very different. He added this innovative propeller. And in doing so, he revolutionized sea travel. The SS Great Britain has since become the model for nearly all modern ships.
Someone described it as the greatest experiment since the creation.
Brunel built the Great Britain to open up a lucrative transatlantic route. But accidents and mismanagement meant in 1852 she was refitted and repurposed for a much more hazardous trip. One that would take her 700 passengers nearly 70 days to complete. The SS Great Britain would now carry emigrants to the brave new world of Australia. It was a long and arduous journey for the hundreds crammed into steerage.
So it's all very snug. You've got to mind your head. I mean, I'm 5'9". Dave, the cameraman, is 6'7". Watch your head, Dave. Beam. He would really struggle in here. Nice comfy bed. Right, let's try and get up here. There we go. That's not too bad. These would have been here, so you've got to mind your head on the beams. And that's it. Imagine months and months living like this with hundreds of people.
Teenage passenger Alan Gilmore recorded his trip in his diary.
We then got the remainder of our luggage stowed in our berths, which are pretty well ventilated, but very confined and dark. Mm-hmm. The stateroom, as it's called, allotted to us, holds four, viz. Father, Brother Matthew, Robert Gow, and myself. The distance between our berths for the purposes of dressing is 2 feet broad and 6 feet long, so confined that only one can dress at once. And even in this small space, we have to build part of our luggage. Well, presumably he means that they had to build and stack all of their cases around them to create room. Oh. How well would you sleep? I guess needs must.
The trip to Australia was non-stop, so everything that was needed had to be stored on board.
This is the pantry, all stocked up, beef broth, leek and potato, mock turtle. These are the ship's biscuits, apparently like mahogany. And that would have been teeming with weevils, little grubs. Preservation of food was a real issue on board. Lots of salt was used, no fridges.
Despite the hardships, the SS Great Britain was a technological wonder. Powered by this huge steam engine, the constant clanging and banging provided the soundtrack to the voyage.
This really was Brunel's mechanical magic.
Absolutely. This is his engineering marvel. And in 1845, when this engine is in place, it is really at the pinnacle of maritime technology.
Nothing like this had been done before.
No, and it is the heart of the ship. You have to imagine it would have been an unbearable environment to be in. Actually, the firemen that would have loaded the coal onto the engine could only stay for 4 hours at a time, so very, very hot, very, very loud.
The SS Great Britain made 32 round trips to Australia before she ran aground in 1886 and was scrapped. Rescued and restored, today she rests in her original Bristol dry dock. A permanent memorial to Brunel and his ship that changed history.